Hello everybody, I wanted to show you what a Nook color looks like after it's been rooted. So the standard Nook toolbar here is this one. And it pops up and it shows you the library, shop, search, extras, web, and whatnot. That goes away. I've got, after I rooted the device, I put a program called Launcher Pro on, and that gives you these other buttons above here. This one actually shows all the apps that I've got installed. And so to start with, you know, the Nook itself comes with certain apps like the web browser and the gallery. If you click on the gallery, you'll see this will take you to your photos and to your videos. And let's see here. Go back to the grid view. So here you'll see if we got a little YouTube video here we can play. It is a multi-touch screen. And let's see, we'll go back. That's the gallery app, and you can do a slideshow with that. I've got a game here called Angry Birds that is quite popular. Other things I've installed. What I did is after I rooted the device, it can get a little bit tricky to find the software. Basically, you can install pretty much any Android software, and those come as a format of APK files. And on an Android phone, you typically have the Google Android Marketplace to navigate to find your apps and to download them. Similar to the App Store on iTunes. But with the rooted Nook, we don't have the market, at least it's not up and running yet. And I wanted to find as many free and open source software programs as possible. So I actually found something here called FDroid. And FDroid is an app store of sorts for only free software. So this is software that you can modify and change and study. And so you could go and download one of these programs. If you like it, you can just use it. If you wanted to change it, you could, or give feedback to the developers. So I installed some apps from here, and I'll just go back here. One of the apps I installed was called Frozen Bubble, which is this kind of game you might be familiar with. You have to destroy the bubbles, and then we'll get out of this. And then I installed an alarm clock app, and here's a VNC application that lets you view other computers remotely. I installed an email app called Canine Mail. It's pretty good, kind of like Outlook Express or Thunderbird for your Nook color. There's a StatusNet app, which lets you interact with Identica and other servers like that. This one here is called gvSIG Mini. And this one's actually a mapping application. So when we go here, we can zoom out, we can pinch and zoom, and this is downloading map data that's from OpenStreetMap right now. But if you want to, you can change the map tiles that you go with, and we could use Google Maps. I'll do Google Satellite. So here's the San Francisco Bay Area in Google Maps satellite. I thought this was one of the most interesting things to see on the iPad. So to see it on a $249 Nook color is quite impressive. Okay, let's see what other apps we have installed. And of course, you know, if you want to install an app in FDroid, it's quite simple. Let's say I wanted to install... You know, they got barcode scanner. Of course, the Nook does not have a camera on it. It doesn't have a microphone. But the iPad has neither of those as well. And let's see. Let's say I want to download this Mandelbrot map. This is a fractal generator. It's as simple as tapping on it, install. It's going to download it over Wi-Fi. Install down here. And then we'll open it. I have to say, installing software on this, let's see, maybe we zoom in, huh? Yeah, this is great. It's a little fractal generator, fractal explorer, putting the processor to the test. The Nook has a 800 megahertz processor and 8 gigabytes of internal storage with 5 usable. But then you can also go ahead and there's an SD card slot right here that you can, micro SD card slot. So you can add more memory, maybe, you know, a 16 or a 32 gigabyte card right now. The rooting process is pretty simple. Basically, you write a an image using DD. If you're on Linux, you do a DD and write an image to an SD card, and then you boot up the Nook with that SD card in. And let's see. If there's any other apps that are worth checking out here? There's some that are installed. You know, they have the Nook comes with the chess program by default. I've had a lot of fun with two apps in particular, one being daap, D-A-A-P. This lets you actually connect your, if you have, say you have all your music in a media server like Rhythmbox. If you have the daap enabled, you can actually stream the music over to this device. And let's see what else, you know, so we can click on one of these guys, see if it'll play. Yeah, so now this is playing music over the internet from my home server. Not recommended, but it works. Another app that's kind of neat with the, you know, it's an iPad competitor type deal is this other one. Let's see, where is it? VLC remote. And if you're familiar with the Apple TV and what an iPhone will do with its the little remote app, this will let you control a VLC instance that's running on another computer. So, you know, for instance, I could have my laptop here running VLC, watching a movie, and I can stop it there, and I can press play, and, you know, I could even eject it, which will take me back and let me navigate my machine for media.